It is the biggest day yet at the AFC Asian Cup Qatar 2023. The first semi-final from the magnificent Ahmed Bin Ali Stadium. Gloriously lit up, as you can see. It is Jordan versus the Korea Republic. And it should be an absolutely fascinating game. Here's how these teams have got this far. Korea Republic needed extra time to get past Australia in the quarterfinals. And on the other side of the draw, Jordan had that magical win over Tajikistan. They're the only team left in the competition who have yet to lift this trophy. One of nine stadiums being used. The final, remember, is on Saturday evening, but we are here at the Ahmed Bin Ali, which seats around 45,000. Perfect conditions. It's just shy of 6 p.m. local time. Pitch looks a picture. We've got some very vociferous fans from both nations who've been here for several hours. Just when we came into the ground, couldn't avoid the flags. They've got megaphones, they've got painted faces, and both sets of supporters obviously want to stay around until the weekend, see if their team can lift the trophy. It's a real David and Goliath battle, to be honest. Republic of Korea came in as one of the tournament favourites. Jordan, well, they have massively overperformed to get this far. So as I say, it's a fascinating matchup. My name's Trevor Harris. Alongside me, delighted to have Roshan Rai. Roshan, let's take Jordan first. I don't think there were too many observers who 4 weeks ago thought, yeah, Jordan are going to make the last four. They haven't really got any superstars. You could maybe say Moussa El-Tamari, who plays it in France at Montpellier. You've got to give a lot of credit, haven't you, to Hussein Amota, the coach?
Yeah, it's been a bit of a magical run into the semi-final by Jordan. Very, very good group stage. Aside from that defeat to Bahrain in the final match, where they didn't really look too interested in getting the win. Otherwise, they've been very consistent in their performances, very consistent in terms of their tactical setup. The shape has generally stayed the same. They know what they're good at, and they've been very disciplined defensively as well and aggressive in the press when they've needed to be. And they know who their key players are up front, and they try and get the ball up to them quickly as soon as they possibly can. And I expect that to be their game plan here again this evening.
Korea are trying to end a 64-year drought to retain the trophy that they won way back in the 1960s for the last time. When you consider some of the players they've had since then, the fact they've got to a World Cup semi-final. We saw at the start about 30 minutes ago when they were announcing the teams, when the likes of Sun Hong-min, Hwang Hee-chan, Lee Gang-in were announced, huge cheers from the Korea fans. Jurgen Klinsmann, the coach, when his picture came up, deathly silent. But he hasn't always had the best relationship with the supporters. However, if he gets them to the final and then wins it, he'll have had the final say, won't he?
Yep, absolutely right. I mean, at the end of the day, he'll be the coach that would have led them to an Asian Cup title. I have to say, I think, you know, Jordan looked like a side who are incredibly well-coached, really well-drilled, and know exactly what their identity is. With Korea Republic, I'm not quite sure. Klinsmann, I think, has messed about a little bit with the tactics and in terms of his lineup and his starting formations, and he's gone with a little bit of a different one for this evening as well. We'll find out what that is a little bit later on.
Yeah, he's been criticised for some of his squad selections, for not living in Korea. But as I say, he's two games away from lifting this title. And we're about 10 seconds away from the two national anthems. Stand by for the music.
أصحاب السمو والمعالي السيدات والسادة يرجى الوقوف في حالة القدرة لعزف النشيد الوطني للأردن. حصلت الوقوف لعزف النشيد الوطني لجمهورية كوريا.
Well, he looks relaxed enough, doesn't he, Jürgen Klinsmann? Of course, he had that long break from the game. Only been manager since last February. Previous job back in 2019 at Hertha Berlin, where he left after only 10 weeks in charge. Clearly loves the game too much to not go back to it. Well, the German boss Hussein Amota says his side's tactics tonight will be vital. Yazid Abuleyna has been the number one keeper all tournament, but there is an enforced change at the back. El Ajalin is suspended, so Baran Mere comes in. El Rababde and Ayad have the difficult job of stopping the supply line to Korea's dangerous frontmen. Rashdan is recalled too, and with Ali Oman banned, there's even more pressure on Yazan Al Neymat up front. They've been here for hours, the Jordan fans in particular. The man in charge tonight is Mohammed Abdullah Hassan of the United Arab Emirates, on the FIFA list for 10 years. And the players have been warned, 25 yellows and 2 reds in his last 5 matches. So I don't want to take too many liberties with the 45-year-old official. Of course, we have VAR in operation today, as we have had it every single match so far. Well, Korea Republic boss, despite the criticism Jürgen Klinsmann's had, he says his whole squad are hungry for success. Jo Hyo-woo is the regular goalkeeper, but a settled defence is disrupted by Kim Min-jae's suspension. Jung Sung-hyun comes in at centre-back. Park Jung-woo only made his debut last year at nearly 30 years of age. He's the main holding midfielder. And, of course, so much revolves around skipper Sun Hong-min, who got the quarter-final winner. Lee Chae-sun comes back into the midfield. Wang Hee-chan moves from the wing to a striking role. What do you think about that, Roche? Wang Hee-chan up front. He has played there for Wolverhampton Wanderers, so it's not as if he's unfamiliar with that role.
No, I'm sure he'll be comfortable playing there, and he's a player who's incredibly fast and pretty quick in terms of getting himself into the channels and in behind that Jordan defence, and that could come in handy for Korea Republic if they do try and bypass that pressing from Jordan. We saw them in the first meeting in the group stage between these two sides. Jordan were not sitting deep, they were sitting almost in the mid-block, and they were pressing very aggressively and together as a team, and that caused Korea Republic a few struggles in the first half of that match. They couldn't really get into their rhythm. I'll tell you what, we might even see Son Heung-min leading the line with Hwang Hee-chan just popping up onto this left-hand side, Lee Kang-in playing off the right.
Away we go then, with Jordan, the underdogs, all in white, attacking the goal away to our right in this first half. Tamri's going to be a threat throughout, you would think. They're already into the danger zone here. Battling away was Al Neymat in the first corner of the game inside the first 20 seconds.
It's already very sharp from Mahmoud Al-Mardi, who's playing in that left wing position in place of Ali Olwan. 17 successful dribbles, Ali Olwan, but Mahmoud Al-Mardi already with a good dribble there.
Corner quickly taken and delivered. That was a half chance. Didn't really make a solid enough connection. And Korea Republic escaped, but my word, a flying start from the Jordanians. It was Mere, the big centre-half, who got in there, but just couldn't divert it, couldn't get enough on it.
Good, quick, aggressive start, exactly what you want. Just put the opposition under pressure. They've won it high up here as well.
Yeah, Al Naymat had it rather gifted to him. Korea looked very nervy in the very early stages here. Need to settle themselves down and spell a possession. First of a loose ball at the moment, though. Here's Al-Rad Abde. Nicely done by El Mahdi. Here he is again. Drawn by Son Yang-woo. They're going to try, obviously, and get the likes of Son and Yi Gang-in on the ball as often as they can. How impressed have you been with Yi Gang-in? He's only 22. Roshan, it's not just the goals he scored, he's got three already in this tournament. He's created 17 chances, he's put in 16 crosses, that's both of those are more than anybody else in the tournament.
Yeah, I was just going to say, he's a, as you mentioned, those numbers there, a chance-creating machine for Korea Republic. He's just so good, so intelligent, able to pick out passes, pick out runners as well. And also, as we saw, not afraid to have a goal from range. We saw a beautiful goal that he scored against Bahrain in the opener. He has taken on a lot of responsibility, and it's great to see Yi Gang-in, you know, making a big contribution in this tournament for Korea Republic so far.
It's Al Mahdi who went down there. You think he's okay? There's Hussein Amota, 54-year-old Moroccan, who's suddenly become a bit of a national hero back home in Jordan. This is Jung Sun Hyun, trying to float it towards Son, and he's floated it very accurately too, to his captain. Double teamed on the far side. He might see a fair bit of that this evening, you sense?
Well, indeed, it's a case of Son Heung-min leading the line this evening, with Hong Hee-chan actually popping up on the left-hand side.
Yeah, I think they might swap a little bit, those two. We will see, I think, Sun raiding down the left on occasion. Defender will get there first. Had to get a sprint on, though, Kim Young-kwon. Not messing around, took the throw really quickly. Here's El Tamari. He's a dangerous customer. Once he gets into that dribbling road, the Montpellier man.
It's so difficult to deal with him as a defender.
Oh, it's reached it again. It maybe should have done better. First touch just left a little bit to be desired from Al Tamari. Korea guilty of giving it away. Yet again, shot from distance. Goalkeeper always had it covered. Rashtan's effort. And it will be a corner.
Yeah, look at this. Brilliant start by Jordan, playing within high intensity, high pressure. They're pressing. They're not giving Korea Republic a chance to get out. Putting some really good challenges. Nizar Al-Rajdan's got a goal from range, a winning goal against Iraq. Forcing a save from Cho Hyun-woo.
So what can they make of this corner? El Mahdi is over it. They've got six waiting in and just around that penalty area. Easily header clear from Jung Si-hyun. Zabu Hashish playing predominantly as a left wing back. A little bit too far out. He caught it really sweetly, Haddad. But from that range, unlikely you'd have thought to beat Jo Hyun-woo, but it was travelling.
Well, they're looking confident here, Jordan. He initially thought about the shot from even further out. Took another touch, got himself closer. Not a bad effort. He gave Cho Hyun-woo something to think about. Went well wide in the end. But it's a nice, confident start from Jordan. Have a look at their starting position as well here. Very high up, trying to disrupt the build-up from the back of Korea Republic. And they're not dropping off.
Just to put it in context a little bit, Korea have never lost to Jordan. But obviously, that record nearly went in the group. Klinsmann saw his side get a very late equaliser in a 2-2 draw.
Well, he was saying, Klinsmann, in the lead-up to this that he almost wishes his side could start matches already a goal down, because he feels that when it's nil-nil, they've got something to lose. There's too much pressure on them. He might just get his wish, and I think he should be careful what he wishes for.
Well, they've trialed in four of their five games, but haven't lost any of them in this competition. So you've got to say resilience is in evidence from Korea. Yeah,
absolutely right. Says a lot about their attitude and their mental resilience and the capacity to drag themselves back into matches, playing under that sort of pressure. There's a lot to be admired. And when you watch them, even in the late stage of a match where they're trailing, they keep their cool, they keep their calm, they believe in their own ability to create opportunities.
If you didn't see the quarterfinal against Australia, they were trailing until stoppage time. And then Song won a penalty, even though he was surrounded by about five defenders, which Huang converted, and then Song scored a wonderful free kick winner in extra time to book their semi-final spot. Here's Rashtek. Force back, that was a decent press. Hanging bomb in evidence, that's what he does. He's a tigerish midfielder, the Korea number six. In possession again now, but that was an errant pass. Haven't really been able to string more than two or three passes together so far, Korea.
Well, look at the way Jordan are not just pressing, but the way they're counter-pressing. The moment they lose it, straight away on, trying to force Korea Republic back and forcing the opposition to play these longer passes forward, and they're quite comfortable dealing with it in the air, Jordan. Trying to keep the opposition as far away from their goal as they can.
And because they really haven't enjoyed much of the football so far, Klinsmann's side, we haven't seen much of either Sun or Huang getting a chance in a forward position. Fifth time for Jordan at the AFC Asian Cup Finals. The quarterfinals, actually on the first two occasions they qualified, 2004 and 2011. They are an improving nation. They've made five of the last six finals, but this is uncharted territory. Never made any semi-final in any international tournament. They did get to the last four at the Western Asian Championships 10 years ago, lost in the final to Qatar.
Well, they lose a lot of speed with Kim Min-jae's suspension, but there's a lot of familiarity in this back line, all of them having played for Ulsan HD. And the goalkeeper as a unit, so there should be a really good understanding in defence for Korea Republic. But yeah, they do lose that bit of speed to deal with Musa Altamari down this side of the pitch.
Laid off by Wen Hee-chan. Touch for Lee Chae-sun, who's been brought into the side tonight. The Mites midfielder.
Very good closing down by Jordan. It's a need and some attention there. Mahmoud Al-Mardi.
Was Lee Gang-in's challenge? Ooh, got a knee in the stomach there, yeah.
Well, Mahmoud Al-Mardi being pushed into that left-wing role for this one. He's featured for them in this tournament at left wing back, but he plays as a left winger for his club side, so it's a position he's very familiar with. I do miss the presence of Ali Olwan in terms of his ability on the ball to take on defenders and get past them, create spaces for his other teammates. Let's see how Mahmoud Al-Mardi is able to fill in. We've already seen him at times as well not try and run out into those wider positions. He's left that space on the left free for Mohamed Abu Hashish to get forward into, and he just drops into that left half space to give Jordan a bit more of a presence in those central areas so they can play through.
Here's Nasib. He's been a virtual ever-present for Jordan since he made his international debut just over 2 years ago. Really solid centre-half. He's had a good tournament so far, but it's hard to find a Jordanian player who hasn't had a good tournament, to be honest. That dramatic match in the round of 16 with Iraq, where they scored twice in injury time. And so many injury time goals. More than 20% of all the goals scored at this tournament have come in either first or second half stoppage time. You can see that the Jordanian fans outnumbering the Korean supporters. Every time Korea get it, the boos start from the Jordan supporters. Swang's little touch, could quite move it on to Hwang In-bom, who was the target. Volleyed forward by Kim Yong-kwon, but rather aimlessly, truth to tell.
Well, you can just see Korea Republic are struggling to get into that passing rhythm. Again, they're finding it difficult to deal with Jordan's pressing, and when they can't play through the middle, they're looking for those longer balls forward, but in the air, Jordan are so strong. Yazan Al-Arab is there, and he's won a couple of aerial duels already. Abdallah Nasib is also strong aerially. And are quite comfortable in dealing with these longer balls forward.
Rashdan made that his, but it's safely back with Jo Hyun-woo. Park Young-woo just enjoying a rare bit of possession, albeit not threatening. They just need to get their foot on the ball, you fancy, at the moment, Korea. Certainly been second best in the first 12 minutes or so. And that's a poor ball. No chance whatsoever of getting on the end of that. Kim Yong-kwon apologises. Klinsmann not impressed. Possession squandered again.
Well, the other thing that the Korea Republic will miss in the absence of Kim Min-jae, aside from his speed, is also his ability to carry the ball forward out from defence and carry it through the lines and let's try and break those units of the opposition.
Haddad will take the throw for Jordan. Well, three Jordanian pro leagues, Hassan Haddad. Actually made his international debut more than a decade ago. That was better. Now, can they move it forward at pace here, Korea? This is Hwang looking for a run. Well marshalled, had to hold it up and come inside. Hwang In-bom. Chae-sung. Really seen Egang in much. He just had a touch. But Jordan done a good job in forcing Korea back yet again. Just for a moment, he thought Hwang Hee-chan fancied a run towards the byline down this near side, but that was quickly closed down. Towards the time he gets the ball, there's a little buzz around the ground. He went down, but the free kick's gone the other way.
It was a clever ball over the top from Kim Yong-kwon. Again, there was a lot of pressure being put on Korea Republic down that side, and he just looked to try and squeeze them out towards the touchline. Kim Yong-kwon at the ball over the top. Nice run from Son Heung-min. Just a bit of contact there. I didn't think there was too much in it at all. Yazan Al-Arab was just right there. Defended it very well. Quick to close down.
It's interesting, though, isn't it? We saw it on the right a few minutes ago. Now we've seen it on the left. As soon as Son picks up the ball, he's surrounded by two white shirts.
That's the intensity and the defensive work that we've seen from Jordan. Amuta will be really happy with this start. And again, you can see, I just have to say once more, just how well coached they are. They know exactly what their roles are, what they have to do.
That's nicely done. Now Tamari, fouled, free kick. Is the referee going for his pocket? Looks like he is. It's going to be the first yellow card of the game. The Hwang In-bom.
From Musa Al-Tamari. Every time he gets it facing forward, only one thing on his mind, which is to run at the opposition, cause problems for them, force them into challenges, force them into giving away free kicks like this. It's gotten Hwang In-bom into trouble.
Should say, by the way, that an amnesty now on yellow cards, so all the yellow cards in previous matches, group matches, round of 16, quarter-final, they've all been wiped, so no one who gets booked is going to miss the final, although obviously if a player's red-carded and their team progress, we won't see them on Saturday. Now, free kick in a semi-threatening position here for Jordan, which Almavi will take, and it's a decent delivery, came a long way through. Another nervous moment for Korea. Ashish has picked it up, but the flag's up on this near side. But on two or three occasions now, Korea have looked indecisive and vulnerable defensively. That was clearly, clearly offside. About three of them you could have chosen there.
Take your pick with that one. Take your pick with that one. But yeah, I mean, this is pretty much what we've seen from Korea Republic in this tournament. These slow starts, these nervy starts to matches, seems to take them quite a bit of time to grow into the game. Even the opening match against Bahrain, and think back to that, go back to that, and even then they were under pressure in the first 20 minutes or so before eventually showing their class. And it's just something that seems to have carried on throughout the competition. But it's a credit to them, they've made it into the semi-final.
Park Young-woo in for Lee Chae-sung. Not getting a minute to settle on the ball, are they? The Jordanians really pressing. Force them back once again. And no question that the likes of Sun and Hwang are not going to be a threat. Well, Korea have got the ball in that kind of a deep position, and now they've lost it. Well, Tamari, he's so quick. He's a good dribbler. Here's a shooting chance. Keeper maybe should have held that. At least he parried it away sideways rather than back out in front of him. It was another half chance for Jordan. They're enjoying themselves here. Al Rahabdeh.
Look at how that chance came about from Jordan. They just sucked Korea Republic into a trap, took it off Park Young-woo in central midfield, and then quick to transition.
Al Rahabdeh on target, but Cho Hyun-woo equal to it that time. This is Sun. Excellent defending. Just got across in time. Al Arab. Worth mentioning, actually, Sun Heung-min's 123rd cap tonight. Puts him now sixth in the all-time list for Korea Republic. 123 and counting, obviously. This is Hwang.
So Young-woo doing a good job out at left back. I think he's more comfortable playing on the right, but can do a job here as well.
Now Son, surely he's offside. He's managed to finish it, but I don't think it's going to count. He looked well beyond the last defender.
Yeah, he took his time with that. The assistant referee, as he's expected to. That's potentially a way forward. It's completely mistimed this run. Good defending. Yazan Al-Arab quick to step up, identifying exactly the moment when he needed to push on and hold that line defensively for Jordan. It's back towards Yazan Al-Arab, did Son Heung-min, so he wasn't aware that Yazan Al-Arab had actually already stepped up. Wanted a pass played earlier.
Yes, I don't think we needed the semi-automated offside technology for that one. He was 2 or 3 metres beyond the Jordanian back line. But as you say, if that ball had been played a fraction earlier, he might well have been in business. Son Heung-min. Jordan may be having rather more possession than most of us expected so far. We're nearly 20 minutes in. We've certainly been the more proactive side. All the way back to Yasin Abu-Layla. Now Nasib can bring it forward.
Haven't really seen, just down this left-hand side of the pitch for Korea Republic, a direct one-on-one battle between Musa Al-Tamari and Seol Young-woo. But it's quite interesting because you have Musa Al-Tamari, it's a left-footed player. Seol Young-woo is right-footed. He's able to defend him on the inside on his favourite foot. And they were looking for that big switch, Yazan Al-Arab. To get it out to Musa Al-Tamari to go one against Seol Young-woo. Well read by Korea Republic's number 22, dropping off early.
This is Al-Arab. Decided he didn't like what he saw in front of him. Korea are actually on a 13-match unbeaten run, despite the criticism of Jürgen Klinsmann from press and public alike. Well, they've won 8 of those, so they're a tough nut to crack. Here's Jung Sun-hyun. Winners of this semi-final, of course, will play either the host Qatar or Iran, who meet tomorrow in the second semi. Once again, Jordan have stolen it. They're very busy in the middle of the park. Waiting on this near touchline is Haddad. Slightly miscontrolled it. Now he's got company. He's playing with a very good challenge. And that's going to be a goal kick.
I really like what Jordan are doing at the moment. If you notice, Lee Kang-in, who's struggling to get involved in the game, he's peeling in off that right-hand side. He's trying to get himself into central areas. But Jordan almost sort of double-teaming him. They've got one player in front of him, one in behind. So it's very difficult to actually find Lee Kang-in in those positions. Instead, it's Park Yong-woo who has to get on the ball a lot. And they're essentially saying to Korea Republic, give it to your number five. And when he goes out into certain areas, because he's not as comfortable in possession as some of these other midfielders, that's when they'll go and press, and that's when they'll take it off him. We've already seen Park Yong-woo lose the ball on a couple of occasions here, and Jordan have been able to break quickly.
Almost feels like Jordan have got an extra man, because they're first at every loose ball, or they have been so far. Korea haven't really been able to seriously threaten them. Here's Kim Yong-gun. So they try to play beyond the pressure for once. The danger was well spotted by Larab, and that's going to be a free kick for Jordan.
And once more, no space for Korea Republic to play through, to pass it short through the middle. So having to go long again, Lee Kang-in was trying to provide the option in behind, but just easily read by Jordan's defence.
And I don't think that's the kind of ball that either Sun or Hwang really want. They want it to feet, or they want it to be into space to run onto. Hwang in Bob. Maybe a chance here. Seol Yong-woo is up from the back. Can he deliver? He can. For the first time they're stretched, and on the volley, way too high from Lee Kang-in. Just snatched at that a little bit. First real sighter that Korea have had.
You look at that, I was just looking at the reaction of Jordan's defence. Great work from Seol Yong-woo down this left-hand side, showing that he's able to twist and turn and use his left foot pretty decently as well. But you just have a look at this there, and they were straight on to the number two, Muhammad Abu Hashish. Jordan's defender saying, you have to go in and close him down quicker. You cannot let him get a shot at goal.
First genuine opportunity for Korea, whose fans have been a little muted so far. We're past the halfway point of the opening period. Jordan have been asking most of the questions up to now. But Yanyu didn't do that particularly convincingly. Oh. Mistake just for a minute. Son thought he might have been in business.
Very difficult for Jordan to really try and play through the middle as well. They're outnumbered in the center. They look to perhaps go a little bit more direct, a little bit of those longer passes employed.
Once again, that's a giveaway. It was a present to Al Naymat. Will he go himself? He might, you know. Still Al Naymat. Keeper had to push it away. And fortunately for Jo Hyun-yu, it didn't fall to a white shirt. But again, Korea's defence torn asunder.
That's good goalkeeping by Jo Hyun-woo. You know, I think he's actually aware of where his defender is and where he needs to push that out to. But Yazan Al Naymat, he's so tricky. It's that directness that they're finding it difficult to deal with at the moment, this Korean defence. Yazan Al Naymat easily away from a couple of defenders. Put the space up for the effort. What a bad effort at goal as well. There he is, out on the left-hand side now.
Just opened up, didn't it? right through the middle for him. Wasn't the worst effort in the world either. Here's Haddad. Now El Tamari. Do look assured on the ball, Jordan. Nicely done by Haddad. And curled in off a spectacular attempt. Very, very difficult. It would have been a wonder goal from El Neymar had that nestled in the top corner.
Well, the approach play is very good again. A bit of concern here because he's clutching his thigh. It was actually an overload at the back post. An extra man there from Jordan. They do so well to get numbers into the box. Here's another look at that early opportunity. Cho Hyun-woo does very well for me there. I think he knows exactly where the position is of the Jordanian attacker on the follow-up, and he knows where his defender is, and he knows exactly how much he needs to get to push it away to safety. He's doing well so far in goal, under lots of pressure at the moment. Jordan looking the much brighter of these two sides.
And their supporters inside the Ahmed Bin Ali Stadium are giving them magnificent support. That's another really poor pass. Now, can El Neymar or El Tamari take advantage? You could see exactly what he was trying to do, El Tamari, just curl it into that top corner. It didn't quite come back enough for him.
You put yourselves under so much pressure when you give it away like that. Jordan live for situations like this, when they can counter, when they can transition quickly. Difficult one in the end for Ussa El Tamari.
It was an absolute present though, wasn't it? Banging bomb. Kim Tae-hun. Now Park Young-woo. Bit of time for EJ Sun for once. This is Hwang Hee-chan. EJ Sun again. And shifted out to that far side. See Kim Tae-hyun trying to come forward. First time we've really seen that from the right back position. We've got the break of the ball here, and here's Sahan Ki-chang. Sun Yung-woo. Oh, that's a lovely give and go. Oh, and that was just a heavy first touch. Otherwise, he might have been in.
I think it's a penalty, you know.
Well, it looks like the referee is saying it was a handball, and he's given the penalty. Kind of all stopped there. Al-Arab has gone down. It will be checked. Deathly silence in the stadium.
Yeah, it was just almost a decision that caught everyone by surprise, really, with how quiet it went. For a sudden, great noise, but Yazan Al-Arab, I think he was late into that challenge with Seol Yong-woo. Beautiful play by Korea Republic. Just gets it away. Oh, no, I think that's going to be overturned. It's actually Seol Yong-woo who makes contact with Yazan Al-Arab. Gets it away. Yeah. Wow. I mean, the referee was convinced that it should have been a penalty. Straight away, he pointed to the spot.
Well, he did, and then he started tapping his hand. I'm quite sure what he meant by that, because certainly no handball issue.
Yeah, he's coming across to have a look, and I think it's been said to him, go and have a review, on-field review, and I think you'll see that the contact was actually made by Seol Yong-woo. Now let's see if he changes his mind or if he sticks to his on-field decision. This is going to be fascinating.
There'll be some noise in the stadium if he does change his mind, I tell you that. After the silence when he initially awarded the spot kick.
Didn't need to take too long, I think, the referee.
There's the cheers. There were the cheers from the Jordan fans. Well, you've got to say, that's great use of VAR. You know, had we not had it, Korea would have got an undeserved penalty. As it is, the decision's been overturned. I think Klinsmann, when he sees a replay of it, will understand that was the right call.
Yeah, absolutely. I think we saw it on the replay as well. Seol Yong-woo actually connected with Yazan Al-Arab. A little bit of a moment of encouragement.
Fair to say that there are those who reckon that the career boss maybe went down a little too easily in his playing days. I would never say that. Some people did. So we're still 0-0. Would have been seriously against the run of play had Korea been given a penalty and scored it. Just over half an hour gone, as you can see.
I think he's does he want Yazan Al-Arab to leave the field of play?
Well, he was down and getting treatment, so he should have to leave the field. Eventually, Yazan Abdullahi will take this free kick. Al-Arab has been waved back on. Sun. Oh, that's a nice little flick. Clanging bomb. Into Sun again. He's got such quick feet. He's done well to make anything of that. And a free header hits the upright. Lee Sun probably should have scored. It came back off the post.
Wow, are we starting to see a shift in momentum now? Lovely flowing move from Korea Republic. That play from Lee Kang-in just to flick it in for Hwang In-bom. And then the cross is perfect as well. A late run from deep by Lee Jae-sung. It gets into the opposition area very well. It's a strong part of his game.
Looking at it again, and maybe I was a tad harsh on him because he was somewhere near the penalty spot, and he really met the header sweetly, but it just wasn't quite accurate enough. He's having a great time at Mainz. He was actually nominated for the Bundesliga team of the season last term. Lee Jae-sung played all three matches for Korea at the World Cup here in Qatar back end of 2022.
He's such a good footballer, Lee Jae-sung. Can play in a number of positions. Great work rate, good technique as well.
Just in the last few minutes, Korea have shown the threat that they carry. This is where Jordan have to be watchful and resilient. Kim Sung-kyu, too much on that, way too much. Got a bit of a history in this country, the coach of Jordan, Hussein Amota. Got a spell in charge of Al Sadd. He actually managed them to the league title. And won a league title as a player here in Qatar. Leila clears. Straight up in the air from Mary. Just starting to be a bit quicker to the loose ball now, Korea, as Hwang In-bom tries to make something of it on the far side. He'll get the throw.
Well, they're looking like they're just perhaps now starting to grow into the game. I mentioned earlier, they are slow starters. Well, they tend to be slow starters, and we've seen from them for the majority of this competition. Maybe now with Jordan just dropping off a little bit slightly, that moment as well with the VAR intervention just helping to shift the rhythm, the momentum of the match.
Kim Yong-kwon. First half is fairly whizzed by. We've only got 10 minutes to go to the break. In the air there, Lee Kang-in. He's only 5'8", not really the main strength of his game. Actually came through the Valencia Youth Academy. Lee Kang-in, cost PSG $20 million US, and actually that looks to be a bit of a bargain the way he started in the French capital.
Well, sloppy again from Korea. Really sloppy, that one. Two central defenders at times. They're passing out from the back. Just hasn't quite been good enough. It's a simple, straightforward ball. Well, it should have been a simple, straightforward ball from Jung Sung Hyun, not to Kim Tae-hyun.
Just wonder if Jordan might pay for their profligacy in front of goal when they had the upper hand. They were on top for the first half an hour, didn't score. Now it's a much more even contest. Oh, that was a high boot, was it? Or the referee's decision was that the head was maybe a bit low. So no free kick against Al Arab for the challenge on Lee Gang-in.
Gang-in just again having to drop very, very deep. He's trying to take Mamoun Al-Mardi with him and then hoping that his teammates will use this space that he's moved away from. We saw Kim Tae-hwan push on down that right-hand side, but once more, a pass just not good enough. Just lacking that quality in their play at the moment, Korea Republic.
Yeah, I think Hwang In-bom thought he was going to make the run, and he didn't. And it looked a pretty poor pass. They just weren't on the same wavelength. It will be a free kick.
San Haddad is having a very strong tournament as well. Gives them such good energy. Jordan's captain down that right-hand side, gets forward so well and also back defensively. Very disciplined Jordanian side, this one.
Chip forward by Naseeb. Young-woo did well. And Jae-sung has moved it on quickly. Hwang In-bom gets it wide. Just couldn't deliver Lee Gang-in. There were plenty of players in the way, but they've managed to recycle it. And they've got three waiting in the penalty area if they can deliver. Almost leading it to each other. Here's Lee Jae-sung. Just trying to find Sung Young-woo. It has reached him now. More by accident than design. It's not the best clearing header. Sun. Better from Korea Republic. Trying to get Lee Gang-in into the game. Look how many white shirts they were trying to charge that down.
Much better passage of play from Korea Republic. Just before it went down to the right-hand side, there was a beautiful one-touch football being played out on the left. They broke free, they were able to move it along quickly, find a space out, and get it to Lee Gang-in, who was then able, I think for really the first time in this match, to run at his defender Abu Hashish.
Well, this is Korea's first corner of the game, and it comes in the 40th minute. Poach a goal here, having been second best for most of this first period. That won't matter if they can find a way through here. Referee having words with Jung Sung Hyun and also Bara Mere. And now he's gone down. Referee's going to have more words. We could be here for a while.
Just taking the opportunity to remind the players once again.
So that's two warnings for that pair. This is number three. Hopefully they got the message by now. Looking for that flick on the near post. It was knocked away by Naseeb in the end. It might come straight back. This is Sung Yung-woo. And again. Oh, again, that was poor delivery. It's never ever going to reach the intended target. And here's Al Tamari for Jordan on the counter. Haddad's delivery. Well, very, very awkward that for Al Neymar. It was kind of slightly behind him.
He quite likes the spectacular, doesn't he? Yes, Al Neymar. We saw him with an earlier ball that was played in. Go for the overhead kick, which was a difficult one. Here's another very difficult one. He just slips as well. Moussa Al-Tamari is asking why didn't he just lay it off. He was free, top of the box. Could have had a touch and laid it off to him, to his teammate, number 10.
He going in battling for it on that far side. He's done well to come away with the ball here, very well. And to find Lee Chae-sung into Wang. Once again, you see the white shirts in two lines, almost daring the Koreans to find a way through. Wang Hee-chae. Oh, he's been dispossessed. Hasn't got much support here, so he's going to have to hold it up. Al-Tamari. Went for the little pass around the corner for Al-Naymat. He's got past two, he's still going! Terrific save! Danger may not still be over. And eventually, it's headed into a safe area. And Kim Tae-hyun can bring it away. In fact, there's a flag up in any case. But what a wonderful piece of skill from Al-Naymat there.
Oh my goodness, that was street football from Yazan Al-Naymat. The way he just shifted it so quickly, moved it away. Have a look at the footwork here. Right to left. Such great close control. Again, Cho Hyun-woo keeping his side in it. They could have at least two goals here, Jordan. They've created some great chances. Just struggling to find a way past Cho Hyun-woo. But this is outstanding work from Yazan Al-Naymat.
Outstanding from him and brilliant too from Cho Hyun-woo in the Korean goal. And it may have come at a cost to the keeper, who is getting some treatment here while you're watching Yazan Al-Naymat. Another look at it, and well worth another look.
Yeah, I don't mind this at all. I don't think he knows too much about that. Cho Hyun-woo just hits his face.
And he got himself in the right place,
yeah,
didn't he?
Just needs to position himself in the right area. Gets himself well positioned. And look, makes a good save.
Might have a headache tomorrow, but worth it. Denied a certain goal there.
But you think about where that started as well. It started from Moussa Al-Tamari playing at the back, almost at that right wing-back position. He was able to intercept the pass, cut it out, transition quickly, get it forward, and then out to Yazan Al-Naymat.
Sol Young-woo. Certainly, he's been far the busier of the two keepers, Cho Hyun-woo. Played in towards Lee Ging-in. Park Young-woo. Chae-sung trying to get Sung Yo-yoo involved at every opportunity, and Hwang's cross was half charged down. He might get another chance here. Surrounded by white shirts, he's done brilliantly to find Lee Chae-sung, and he couldn't keep it.
Should be
he did everything he could to get out of the way, didn't he?
Well, Jordan's possession anyway.
Offside. So we're only a few seconds away from completing the first 45. Understand there's going to be 5 minutes of additional time to add at the end of this first half. There's the confirmation from the fourth official, and we're playing those 5 minutes now.
Yazan Al-Naymat. Come back to Yazan Al-Naymat as we have a look at David Beckham watching on.
Yeah, his Inter Miami team were in Saudi Arabia last week, played against Al Hilal and Al Nasser. Riyadh Cup.
They've been busy.
When I say his, he's the president and co-owner, David Beckham. Wang Hee-chae. Just a fraction too much on the pass, otherwise Kim Tae-hyun would have been in.
I was just going to say, Yazan Al Naimat earlier coming into this match with 7 successful dribbles. That number is pretty sure gone up quite a bit. The number of successful dribbles he's had in this one. It's been a frustrating first half for Korea Republic. Yi Kang in earlier and he was flagged for offside. Just looked really annoyed. Haven't been able to get their key attacking players on the ball too much in this first half, at least on a consistent basis, and they've been really sloppy with some of their passing from out the back.
Well, it's at a high boot. The referee will give the free kick here for Korea. Hwang Hee-chan certainly felt it. It'll be a yellow card for Haddad by the look of it.
Yeah, it took a bit of time to get the card out because I was just thinking that should be a yellow.
Dangerous play for sure.
Yeah, should be a yellow. Business having his foot right up there. And he puts his foot there because he knows he was caught out of position. So absolutely the right call made by the referee.
So one player now from each side in the notebook. Hwang In-bom having been cautioned earlier. Well, there's never a bad time to score, but this would be a particularly good one just before the interval. First half stoppage time. Having been outplayed for much of the half. Chance here. They can conjure up a decent delivery. Might have the venom on it, did it, from Yi Kang In. Looking to really whip it in with pace, and it's almost a bit of a half-hearted delivery. Now we've got Al Tamari down injured.
There was an injury concern with Musa Al Tamari coming into this one. When he came off against Tajikistan, had some treatment on his right groin or his upper thigh, is heavily strapped up. Not sure he would have trained too much in the lead up to this, just keep him rested.
Hooked over his own shoulder by Son Yung-woo. Son, for once only had one defender to deal with, but wasn't really in a particularly advanced position. Park Young-woo, that's nearly a very good ball. He saw the run that his captain had made, Sun Heung-min, right down the middle. Wasn't that far away from finding it. Pretty silly challenge from Yi Kang In. It's always going to do that, the defender. Just any excuse to go down. Just put him out of trouble by getting him a free kick.
Well, he did. This part was good initially, the closing down. That part not so good, shoving the back. I mean, when you've got the defender in a position like that, keep him under pressure. Instead, you've given him an easy way out after doing a lot of hard work. He's got a lot of hard work ahead of him. And that halftime break, Megan Klinsmann, his coaching staff, because they're lacking ideas in this match. And they are struggling on the defensive side of things to deal with Jordan's play. It's vibrant, it's exciting. It's been really good to watch.
Last few seconds then of the opening period. I think Koreans will be relatively happy to hear the halftime whistle. Certainly satisfied to get in at 0-0 after some of the chances that Jordan have had. Is there going to be time for one final attack? Hwang Hee-chan, still going. Sol Yung-woo can deliver. It's not a bad ball, and it deserved a much better finish. Well, they could have literally struck with what would have been the last kick of the half. It's probably one of those situations where you'd want Sun Heung-min on the end of it. That was a pretty woeful attempt, truth to tell, and it rather sums up Korea's first half. Poor effort from Hwang In-bom. We've had a fascinating first 45 minutes, though. It's Jordan 0, Korea Republic 0. And certainly Jordan will be far, far the happier side you'd have thought going in at half-time, even though they'll be disappointed not to be ahead.
Yeah, just that. I think they would have wanted to have at least had a goal scored here, because they've been the better side in this one. They've caused lots of problems, and they've really restricted Korea Republic in this first half.
Chance at the end that Hwang In-bom couldn't take. Lee Chae-sung heading against the post, but other than that, and the penalty that was very quickly overturned by VAR, it's been all Jordan. Yazan Al-Naymat has come closest. A brilliant piece of skill and a shot that hit Jo Hyun-yu on the head. Keeper has also made a couple of other decent stops. But a half-time here at the Ahmed Bin Ali Stadium, first semi-final of the AFC Asian Cup Qatar 2023. It's Jordan 0, Korea 0. emerging now from the dressing room. Don't appear to have been any changes made by either coach. And away we go for the start of this second half. Just joining us, Korea in the dark shirts, already on the attack with Lee Gang In. Maybe wasn't quite as influential as he would have wanted to be in the first half. Just a fraction too far for Al Neymat at the other end. Had that one good chance on the volley. Lee Chae-sung, Lee Gang In, which he couldn't take. Some ways, surprising, it is still 0-0 because both teams have had presentable opportunities.
Yeah, I think Jordan have had the better opportunities. I think they should have at least a goal. Cho Hyun-woo has been very busy keeping them out with some really good saves. Yazan Al-Naimat lively up front for Jordan. Musa Al-Tamari as well working incredibly hard. Their work off the ball as well has been really superb from Jordan.
What a lazy clearance from Kim Tae-han. Could easily have played his team into trouble there. It's going to be a free kick. That's gone, obviously, Jordan's way. Good work from Nazar Rashtan.
Korea Republic didn't have any real answers to the aggressiveness of the press from Jordan. Couldn't find a way out.
Adan's cross, scooped away by Kim Yong-kwon.
Maybe it's the expectation, so close to a place in the final, but can't really use that as an excuse, can you? Knew coming into this that there would be a lot of pressure on their shoulders.
Not only are they unbeaten in 13, Korea, but they've scored in 11 straight games. One might be all they need tonight. Wang Hee-chan. Free Gang In, looking for Son, just a little bit too much on it. And if they start working those combinations, the likes of Lee Gang In and Sun Heung-min, Jordan might have a problem.
Well, really with Korea Republic here, just have a look at them in their starting position in this second half. They're just pushing up, the defensive line is a lot higher. At times in the first 45, Jordan could easily play it out from the back. It just seems to me like Korea Republic are going to be a little bit more aggressive in their pressing as a team in the second half.
Long from Kim Tae-han. Son was first to it, just quite escaped the attentions of Yazan Al-Arab, who gives it the fist pump for stopping one of the world's best players.
He's done a great job. Has another rub in this competition, and here again against Son Heung-min, who's tried to drag him out of position. He's moved across that forward line into the left and right channels, and Yazan Al-Arab has always been there. He's not given Son Heung-min really too many opportunities to turn and face towards goal.
Sun-Hyun. Again, there weren't too many options in front of him, not maybe enough players making runs. Gang in. Did pick out Lee Chae-sung, but he couldn't keep it.
Good there from Korea Republic. They're the ones now squeezing. And they've lost it here. Lee Chae-sung closing down, making sure there wasn't a pass out to Usal Tamari. Lee Kang-in getting a lot more involved. You can see already drifting in. More of these central positions he's taking up.
Better ball that from Kim Young-gun. Park Young-woo. Space near side. Kim Tae-han. Playing a bomb outside here, but again, see that Jordanian press is on. They're just giving them no time, no room really in which to work.
Yeah, they've been very good. This is a great example of, you know, not allowing the opposition to have that time and space to turn. The back towards goal going close down. Make that pass it backwards. Make them pass it sideways. Job done. They're working very hard without the ball against it, Jordan. But that's something we've seen from them a lot of in this competition. A change in the setup as well from Korea Republic. Lee Kang-in, as I mentioned, playing more of a central role, and at times he's rotating. Either have Lee Chae-sung or Hong In-bum coming out onto this right-hand side. But Lee Kang-in very much staying in the middle, looking to be the playmaker.
This is Kim Tae-hoon. They're filling the box now, Korea. And that's way too close to the goalkeeper. Yeah, I just wonder if the fact that Lee Kang-in's now playing centrally maybe is partly a reflection of the fact he got no change out of the fullback in the first half.
Yeah, they couldn't find passes out to Lee Kang-in in that first half. He was getting really frustrated because he wasn't involved in the match to the extent we know he can be. But you just see it here as well. He's just rotating, swapping it around, keeping Jordan guessing in those areas. It's just about trying to get him in space, Lee Kang-in in space, so that he can play those passes, so that he can run the game for them, because he creates opportunities with the quality of his passing, with his vision and his technique.
Banging bomb for Korea. Kim Tae-han, former Champions League winner with Jeonbuk. A bit short, and it's been picked off, and now Jordan might be in business with Altamari, and they've scored. It's a superb finish from Yazan El Neymat. Korea punished for giving it away, and this time Jordan took full advantage. Their fans going absolutely crazy, and Yazan El Neymat has put unfancied, unfashionable Jordan in sight of the final. But a poor error from Kim Young-gun.
It was coming. It was coming. Another mistake in possession by Korea Republic. Again, it's given away. Poor pass. Musal Tamari quick to get on the end of it. Look at how he breaks forward. Great speed, wonderful awareness. Perfect weight on that pass as well. Keeps the momentum of the move going. Puts it in such a good position in front of Yazan El Neymat, so he doesn't have to break his stride. He can run onto it and he can lift it beautifully over Cho Hyun-woo, who is helpless this time. Great transition. I said in the first half, they live for situations like that, Jordan. And they have punished Korea Republic this time, having to come back again from a goal down.
Well, we've said they've trailed four of their five matches so far and haven't lost any of them. Here's another test of Korea's ability to bounce back. Really was an exquisite finish from Yazan El Neymat after Musa Altamari's pinpoint pass had set him up. And he's getting the crowd going, if they weren't already, which I can assure you they are. Right round the ground, Jordanian flags being waved. A lot of noise inside the Ahmed Ben Ali Stadium.
look at Musa Al-Tamari again. I mean, there's a reason why he's playing his football in Europe. I mean, he's working up and down, Musa Al-Tamari. There's a lot of talk about his quality going forward and the speed he has, but his work rate without the ball is excellent.
Well, here's a positive change. Taking off a defensive midfielder, Park Yong-woo, and putting on striker Cho Kyu-sung.
He's had a poor game, Park Yong-woo. I think he was the player who played that pass short, was cut out by Musa Al-Tamari, and not the first time in this match. He could be in trouble here again.
Yeah, they've stolen it once more. Himat trying to make something of it. But Korea, time and again, the architects of their own demise. Able to smuggle it away on this occasion. Doesn't look like Jordan are going to try and settle this lead. And I don't think that would be a wise policy, actually. They look much more dangerous when they're actually going at the Koreans.
Yeah, just keep it up. Keep going the way they have. And it's even better for Jordan now. They've got the goal. They thrive on opposition coming at them, having the possession, leaving spaces in behind.
Right from Wang Yicheng. He going in and again. It was a sloppy pass. And Jordan have been gifted possession. They're trying to get numbers up in support. Might not need any support. It's a clever little backflip. Didn't quite work. But a great run again from Yazan El Neymar. How much ground has he covered tonight?
Nizal Rajdan working incredibly hard. He was getting into that advanced area, carrying it into the box and then looking for support. He was all alone waiting for that support to arrive, surrounded by Korean defenders who were afraid to put a challenge in. Just going for that back heel, looking for a little bit of help. We're eventually able to get that away. Listen to the atmosphere here, just incredible.
Symphony of sound around the ground. And it's Jordanian voices that you can hear. Headed away confidently by Nessie. And that's going to be a free kick. And now, anything that Jordan can do just to slow the game down a little bit. Wasn't a particularly pretty challenge, that, from Jun Sung-yun. Only a bit fortunate not to get booked for it, actually.
Just making contact with the left leg of Ozan Al-Naymar.
He doesn't need the megaphone. They're loud enough without it.
Don't need the drums as well. Just wonderful. Just feel like an away game for Korea Republic. In fact, it was like this even during the warm-ups.
Don't imagine the headlines will make good reading for him if the scoreline stays this way. But still plenty of time, more than half an hour for Korea to find an equaliser, try and find a way back into this semi-final. It's broken to El Mahdi. Long towards Sun Heung-min. Can they get a bit of magic from the talisman? Excellent foot in from Mere, who's played him pretty well.
Yeah, good challenge. Really well timed from Barra. And he hasn't seen too much football in this competition. Coming into this one, I think just 5 minutes of action from Barra. And once he made that challenge, so he looked up.
You wouldn't say he was a regular in this team. Made his debut back in 2016, it's only his 14th cap tonight, but he's done a sterling job. And he has to continue that as Jordan defend this corner. Oh, keeper was nowhere. He was very, very fortunate. It was almost a wonderful introduction for Cho Kyu-sung.
Yeah, put himself in that. Not the best position here. The goalkeeper, Yazid, completely makes a meal of that. Perhaps he will say he hasn't had enough practice. Hasn't had much of an opportunity to get involved.
just think, though, that Cho Gyuntsu maybe should have put that on target,
yep.
because the goalkeeper was nowhere near him. If he could just have got it a little lower and headed it down, he would have scored.
Well, he knows it as well. He saw his reaction. Really good chance for Korea to get something from a set piece in a game where they really struggled to create openings in general play. It's an issue here on the sidelines as well with number 15, Jung Sung Hyun. Just working on his arm. He's back up. Need to go again. He's just feeling his shoulder after that challenge that he put in on Yazan Al-Naimat. So Z gets some attention as well.
Well, the goalkeeper's back on his feet. Looks okay. Well, they arrived at the stadium dreaming that maybe this fairy tale run could continue. They're half an hour away from seeing their team in the final. I don't think even the most optimistic Jordan supporter would have expected that at the start of this tournament. But they're not there yet.
You know, they look so relaxed in their play, Jordan. They're playing with a lot of freedom. I think it's not much in the way of expectation, as you mentioned. And the chance to really continue with this history-making campaign. They look so fired up, they look organized. If they can maintain their intensity levels, that's the question here. Can they hold out?
Down the line from Kim Tae-hoon. Snap tackle to stop Lee Chae-sung in his tracks.
It's Barak. He should be all right. He's moving his ankle quite a bit. At the moment, you see a lot of movement from a player. Tend to be okay. Painful one. Just on the outside of his foot. But yeah, he's all right.
Chase trying to make something of that, but it's going to be a Jordan throw. Wonder if he's considering changes. I thought he'd want to disrupt the rhythm just yet.
I think it's looking good for them so far. You don't want to change it up too much in these moments, in these situations. I was just having a look at how long it took Jordan to take that throw in, but you can expect that that's what's going to happen. And that's why Yi Kang-in actually came across to the referee to say, look, you've got to be on top of this now because they've got the goal. They're going to look to try and take their time to slow the game down. There, he's already been told that he needs to get on with it.
He's going to take some action. So Al-Hashish is in the book for time wasting. Al-Naimat, not a bad ball that either, is it? And he did saving, brilliant effort from Al-Tamari. And once again, Jo Hyun-yu to the rescue for Korea.
Yeah, look, the way they're able to just change positions, Yazan Al-Naimat as he drops off, Musa Al-Tamari then uses the space as a pass over the top. It's a really good effort because as he connected with that, the ball was almost behind him. Still able to get lots of power on it.
If they get a second, Jordan, you would find it tough to see Korea coming back. And they are threatening it. Here's the corner. Keeper got something on it. Actually, a half-decent intervention again from Jo Hyun-yu. A good distance. Look at all those players around Yi Kang-in. Awkward bounce that. For Sun Heung-min to deal with. Hasn't really had a sniff tonight, has he? I can't remember one threatening run that he's made.
I was thinking exactly the same thing. He hasn't been involved at all, Sun Heung-min, and he was playing as that target man, which I don't think is really his game. You know, trying to fight with central defenders physically, balls played in the air into him. I don't think he's been able to win many of them or any of them. Jordan would be quite happy to deal with those in the air. That's why Cho Kyu-sung has just come on to give them more of a presence as that proper center forward, a target man in terms of the profile. Even Hwang Hee-chan has been pretty quiet.
Nowhere for him to go there, that's for sure. They've just looked devoid of ideas, and that's not something you would usually say about Korea, truth to tell. Crowd turn up the volume again. This is Hwang In-bom looking to make inroads. How many times have they given it away tonight? Charging forward again. Neymar. Oh, what a goal that is! That is fantastic from El Tamari. He's taken on half of the Korea side, and Jordan are in dreamland. Surely they've got one foot in the final, and 2-0 does not flatter them at all. Once again, that Korea defence was ripped to pieces.
Torn apart. Musa Altamari. Incredible work by Jordan's number 10. Ehsan Haddad has just got his head in his hands. Look at this finish as well. Keeps his composure. A brilliant run from off the right-hand side. He takes on three defenders, hangs on to it. Great close control. And then at that moment, the most important moment, the finish. He remembers his quality, his technique, and his composure. Uses those defenders to block off that eye line of Cho Hyun-woo and just bends it around him. They're good value for this, you know, Jordan.
Absolutely. He literally passed it into the net. I just wonder whether the goalkeeper was maybe a fraction late to get down. I hear what you say, that maybe he was partially unsighted. But either way, certainly El Tamari won't care, and nor will anyone of a Jordan persuasion. Because now, Korea have a monumental task to get back into this tie. Midway through the second half, and they trail 2-0, having come on as big favourites, having started as big favourites.
Now, there was another number 10, Argentinian number 10, who would have been proud of that goal, was here in Qatar as well.
Well, you can't give him higher praise than that. Look at this, Elamat's taking on the whole of Korea again. Took about three to stop him. Lee Gang in. Hwang In-bom. Well, they've got to gamble a little bit now, Korea. Lee Chae-sung. Only a throw. They need more than that. 66 minutes, the official goal time. Absolutely no room to turn. They do get forward so quickly, Jordan. Gang in, a bit of a blind alley there, he gang in.
Great work. Again, just the defending has been top-notch from Jordan. Double team. That time around, it was Nur Al-Rawab there coming across to help out Abu Hashish.
Hwang In-bom. I think one of the things that will have really disappointed Jurgen Klinsmann is it doesn't look as though enough of the Koreans want to make penetrating runs. It's not enough movement. Hasn't really been since the first whistle, truth to tell. Here's Son Yung-woo on that far side. Back to Hwang In-bom. Once again, they were queuing up to block the cross. Kim Tae-han's pass. Maybe this is a little more threatening. Son. going in. That's a decent ball. He's in here. Is that a penalty? No, it's not.
Great
perfectly
challenge.
Timed tackle.
Great challenge. Brilliant stuff from Abu Hashish. Just have a look at this. Lovely work from Korea Republic. The give and go. He's in there and he gets a toe on it.
Corner taken quickly. Kim Tae-han. That's well won. Up from the back, Sun Young. But the flag is up and it'll come to nothing. And we're inside the last 20 minutes.
Another look at this. Abu Hashish, he had to make that. Was there a little bit of a clip earlier? Wasn't picked up by the referee or the VAR. Challenge was made. He thinks it should have been a penalty. It's a good one for me. And Korea Republic haven't done enough of that. Enough of that. An intricate, good, quick play in tight spaces, give and go. Trying to break that structure of Jordan's defensive line. Hasn't been enough quality from Korea Republic in this one. Another temptation here from Jordan is to sit back and sit back a little bit deeper, but they should probably carry on doing what they've been doing so far. It's worked out well.
Well, where does he go from here, Jurgen Klinsmann? He's already made one change. He's put the man who started the tournament as his main striker on. We know he's not going to take Sun Heung-min off, surely not going to take Hwang Hee-chan off either.
I'm coming into this one, I don't know if he's quite figured out what kind of formation, what kind of style or what the identity is. You know, he's had 4-4-2, he's had 4-3-3, 4-2-3-1. He's played with a back three or back five against Saudi Arabia. It just seems like he's still trying to work it out. It shouldn't be the case.
Well, formations are one thing, and I hear what you say, but the other thing is, are the players really playing for him? Because if you believe what you read in a lot of newspapers, may well not be the case.
Well, a lot of it is us on the outside really speculating, isn't it? I mean, what we see in terms of body language, they're trying to read perhaps a bit too much in those situations. But we had this chat on the way here, on the way to the venue, and it said, it looks like a side that is playing for themselves, playing more for Sun Heung-min, who's their man out on the pitch, playing for their country, rather than really, you know, being behind Jurgen Klinsmann. But that should be a more of a powerful motivator anyway.
Wang couldn't control it. It's going to be a Jordan ball. And there are scowls and sorrowful looks already from some of the Korean players out there.
I think, Trevor, the thing with Korea Republic here is for the quality that they have, we haven't yet seen them in this competition, throughout this competition, put in a complete performance over 90 minutes. A complete controlled performance over 90 minutes.
Well, unless they do something dramatic, we're not going to see it, are we? Because they're on the verge of elimination here, unless. And that's another woeful ball. That is absolutely symptomatic of Korea tonight. Hand of apology from Cho Kyu-sung. But it just hasn't been good enough. For a team that are ranked 23rd in the world, they have not played like it.
Now, there's been far too much of that. Far too much of that, that lack of quality in their play. Passes going astray, players making individual errors.
He's done really well to win the throw there, Abu Hashish.
The right moment, is it not the right match to have an off day? Major semi-final.
Gonna be a corner, and that's absolutely perfect as far as Jordan are concerned. I love the way he's got the button, and I think his mate's got the actual megaphone. That's teamwork for you. Well, if this goes in, surely the game's up for Korea. Al Arabi is up from the back and he's dangerous in the air. It's going to be a foul on the goalkeeper.
It was really late there. Yazan Al Arab.
Doesn't look like a man you'd argue with, does
no.
he?
You know, I think it says a lot as well if Cho Hyun-woo is your best player. If your goalkeeper is your best player, then that says quite a bit. And he has been Korea Republic's man of the match.
Country with a population of only around 11 million. At the moment, there are 11 million very happy back home. Here's Hang Hee-chan. Well, at least they tried to get it into the box early. We haven't seen much of that from Korea. 15 minutes left.
Well, still time, and they need one very quickly.
Son. I don't mind seeing him in that position. Well, that's neatly played. And he was accompanied by two defenders there, each chasing literally within moments of getting it.
I don't know how you explain this. I struggle to explain this. They're playing so much better now. It's almost as if they've just lost all that pressure and that expectation. Nothing to lose, so all this high-quality play starts to come out again.
Corner didn't beat the first defender. Disappointing that from Korea. Hang Hee-chan. Corner kick. I don't think they can quite believe what they've watched from their team tonight, the Korea fans. Not just the fact that they're behind, but they've just been comprehensively outplayed pretty much from the first whistle. Korea have played the corner short, putting the box towards Hang Hee-chan, who won it, couldn't do anything with it. Well, Tamari has gone down, but it's not going to get the decision.
Struggling with a bit of cramp perhaps as well.
I don't think the referee should stop the game here. It's not a head injury. It's right by the touchline. He can roll across and get treatment if he wants to.
Yeah, absolutely right.
Played in towards Sul Yong-woo, but he won't get to that.
And now he decides to just go over the line for some treatment. The moment it goes out for a goal kick, he goes across. He was hoping that Korea Republic would put it out. They're well within their rights to carry on, to keep playing, play to the whistle. He set such a good game for them, Musa Altamari. He's worked very hard up and down that right-hand side. Can understand why he's struggling with a bit of cramp. Again, another look at this goal. Pass one, pass two, pass three. And then past Cho Hyun-woo with the finish.
It's just a mesmeric run and the coolest finish you'll ever see. So I said at the time, he literally just passed it into the net.
The thing that I've noticed about Musa Altamari as well is when he's running with it, that close control is excellent at pace. And when it does bounce off a defender, he's somehow got this ability to retain possession.
In for Lee Chae-sung. Banging bomb. Now Lee Gang In. They need something and they need it quickly, Korea. Kim Tae-han. That's a much better cross. Brilliant defending. Just got in the way. Haddad. Otherwise, it might well have been 2-1. He had man in black right behind him. Again, they play it early. For once, his control just let him down. It was Al Mahdi, actually, in a very advanced position there.
He's waiting to come on. Musa Altamari still off the field of play.
Looks like Korea are going to make a couple of changes imminently. I'm going to get sick of saying that Korea have lost it, but they have. Once they give it straight back. Lee Chae-sung, it's going to come off in a minute, unless he does something astonishing here. Lee Gang In. Sun Hong-min, that's a nice turn. First real run he's had, and a lovely ball too. The cross was blocked. Their defending has been absolutely phenomenal. That time it was Ishan Haddad.
Yeah, I mean, everyone from this Jordan side, they've just defended so well. Put himself in some really good positions. They worked hard, they've tracked back, shown that defensive intensity to go along with the attacking intensity we've seen from them. So we have a look at a couple of changes here.
Yeah, well, it's a rare involvement for Yang Hyun-jun there, the Celtic midfielder. Something of a controversial pick, actually. It's hardly featured. And Jeongwoo Myung is also on. Two players that have been withdrawn, Lee Chae-sun and Hwang Hee-chan. Hasn't been his night for sure, the Wolverhampton Wanderers player.
Just having a look at the touchline as well, the technical area of Korea Republic. It's nice. Lee Chae-sun just went to his coach Jurgen Klinsmann, and there was a nice moment between the two.
Looks like they're going to make a change shortly as well. Jordan, they've got Anas Al-Awadat, the midfielder, poised to enter the fray. Inside the last 10 minutes of normal time, but I reckon we're going to have quite a bit to add on. There's been a fair amount of time wasting. Just haven't really looked like breaking through, have they, Korea, since they fell behind. Banging bomb. No reaction to going one goal down, and pretty much the same when the second went in. Altamari's away again. Brilliant close control, he really has. Two to stop him, and he's got the throw.
Well, everyone's been talking about Son Heung-min and Lee Kang-in, and these players playing for good clubs at a good level. And Musa Altamari has outshone them.
Tell you what, her classmates are going to be so jealous when she gets back to school. She says, I was there, that semi-final against Korea. It really is going to be almost certainly now, and I was there moment for all these Jordanian fans inside the ground whose team have done them proud, unless there is some kind of remarkable career comeback in the last, well, probably going to be 7 minutes plus, maybe another six or seven after that. While he's on the pitch, Son Heung-min, there's always hope. Well, there was no foul. He really has been largely ineffective tonight. That wasn't the cleverest of challenges, it really wasn't. And it's going to be a card for Jun Sung-kyun, and I don't think he can have any complaints about it.
Yeah, just frustration, I think, getting nowhere near Yazan Al-Naimar, who's so intelligent. He knows exactly what's happening here. He sees the defender coming over his shoulder and just knows a touch away, and the momentum from Jun Sung-kyun is going to take him into Yazan Al-Naimar and that challenge and a yellow card. But some of the tackling from Jordan has just been at a high level.
Well, that is going to be Al-Naimar's last involvement, because he is coming off here, albeit on a stretcher. And Al-Awadat is on, number 25. Midfielder who plays at the Al-Wadat club in the Jordanian Pro League. But he's done damage tonight, Yazan Al-Naimar, with that opening goal. Hopefully, from their point of view at least, they should be able to see it out, you would think, from here. A little bit of solidity in the middle of the park provided by Al-Awadat.
Big hug for Yazan Al-Naimar as well from his coach, Hussein Amuta, and he's just taking the congratulations. Not done yet, but they are getting closer and closer.
Nice control from Rashdan. Shot was a little off target, but it'll waste a little bit of time.
Now he's another who's had a very solid, steady tournament. He's Al-Rashdan in central midfield. big part of their setup, of their lineup in that position. Fresh legs here, having missed out through suspension in that quarterfinal.
First touch for Yang Yunjun. Just doesn't really look like a great deal of urgency about this career performance, even though they're two goals down, less than 5 minutes to go of normal time in the second half.
Just don't have any real clear-cut attacking ideas. And yes, it is difficult playing against a deep block. It is, when there's very little space to work with. And you're playing against a side who look incredibly hungry. You look at the desire from Jordan's players, putting themselves about, working so hard.
Kim Tae-han's delivery, keeper comes. Not particularly orthodox, but at least he got it out. For now, shot was driven back in fiercely. But they were queuing up again to block it. Brandy and Bob. Jong-woo Young shovels it wide. Bang in bomb again. Would set up a grandstand finish if they could get one back here. Things nervous for Jordan. Jong-woo Young again. Look how deep suddenly Sun Hung-min's playing. Anyway, gets to see the ball. A better pass. He could be in here, Gang-in, but again, they were brilliantly organised, superbly well drilled, and now they're coming forward on the counter attack here.
Nizal Rajdan, again, just too many white shirts. You get past one, and suddenly there's another two in front of you. It's incredible.
And like I said earlier, it almost looks at times like they've got an extra man on the pitch. Jordan again have a player down. They're not going to kick the ball out, Korea, that's fine, they don't have to, it's not a head injury. Banging bomb. Again, no movement inside the penalty area. Banging bomb's gone for the return, he's hooked it back in. The header was actually more of a defensive one. Accidentally got it back, and look at this. They're still so full of running, Jordan. Al-Tamhari's just off on his travels again. It was almost a repeat performance. He tried to pass it into the net again.
He probably should have played in Anas on the right side of him.
Well, here's Cho Kyu-sung. Could get one back here. He's still going. Now, is that a penalty? No, it's not.
No, he's going to be booked.
Simulation. Sums up their night. And you just, from the body language, you suspect the referee's got that right.
He just couldn't get away, could he? Oh, that's that's shocking. That's just pure desperation there from Cho Kyu-sung. Really desperately trying to get something for his side. He didn't quite have the speed to break away. He was played in behind, but just didn't have the acceleration or the speed to get away from that back line. Again, the recovery running.
Might be a few watching Hollywood who took note of that. Give him a job. That really was ridiculous.
I can see that some of these Korea Republic players are struggling as well. I think they've put in so much effort in their run into the semi-final. You can see lots of them with the strapping, heavy strapping around the knees. But the same can be said of the other side who are still in this competition. Coming into this, the schedule is brutal. You're working so hard, you're trying to get recovered, and you have to. You're never going to be at 100%. You have to play, you have to suffer and play through that pain.
And also, I think that's a good point you make, Jordan are going to have an extra day's rest, whoever they meet in Saturday's final.
And they're doing this without two key players as well, in Ali Olwan and Salim Al-Jalin. The two of them are going to be
back for the final. Yeah absolutely. We're hearing that there's going to be 8 minutes of stoppage time. Looks like a double substitution, actually, upcoming for Jordan. So Nour Al Rahabdeh is coming off. Nizar Rashdan is also off. I beg your pardon, Mahmoud Al Mahdi is the man who's made way. And Rajeri Ayad and Ibrahim Salah are the two who are going to come on. And we are into 8 minutes of stoppage time.
Well, hang on. They wanted to make the change and then they just changed their minds.
Yeah, they're still hovering by the touchline. Looked like they were literally about to enter the playing arena, but something's happened there. Anyhow, they've got the ball. As long as they've got that, they're fine, Jordan. Al-Amadat. Rashdan. Well, now they probably can make the change if they want to, and indeed the ball's coming up. So just to reiterate, Ibrahim Salah for Mahmoud Al Mahdi. He's had a very good game, mind you. There's no one who hasn't in white. There's our Rashdan, the other man coming off. So he's going to have pretty much a full squad to pick from, Hussein Amota, for the final, assuming there's not some very, very late drama. And Jurgen Klinsmann and his team, in all likelihood, will be back on the plane tomorrow.
Might just be a little bit too much for them to do. Seen them show some great resilience, but look at this from Jordan as well. They're pressing, they're harrying, they're pushing them back. Not making it easy at all for Korea Republic.
Kim Yong-won. Do you think too often the plan for Korea in this tournament has been give it to Sun Hong-min and hope he produces some magic? Football's a team game. Seen that perfectly evidenced tonight.
What a job he's done. What an absolute beauty of a job he's done, Amuta.
In it comes. Goalkeeper changed his mind then. And he needed helping out, and he was helped out in the nick of time by Mohamed Abu Shashish.
Yeah, he owes them all, the goalkeeper, Yazid. He's looked a little bit shaky at times with his decision-making, but he owes his entire defence a round of tea, I think, because they've been brilliant in front of him.
The organisation is such a testament to Hussein Al-Mota, the coach, and the spirit. Here's the corner for Korea. Repelled, as everything else has been tonight. Back in it goes. Only a throw. 3.5 minutes of stoppage time gone. Take something sensational now from Korea to get back into it. Yi Gang In trying to make a beeline for the byline. No joy. Whacked away by Salah. This is Son picking the ball up from his own goalkeeper. That's how frustrated he is. He wants to go that far back to get it. Now plays the long diagonal, plays it perfectly, actually. Jung Yu-young, Hwang In-bom. Well, that's not a bad cross for once. Yeah, see, Abu Dhabi's decision-making was spot on, and so was his handling.
He really hasn't had much to do in this one. And it's a sign of just how good Jordan have been. But just there when they needed him to step out, lovely pass played through, to step out and claim, and ease the pressure on his defence, he did exactly that. Trevor, 0 shots on target for Korea Republic, 6, just 6 in total compared to 17 for Jordan.
They've stolen it again, they're going to get a corner. As we move into the 6th minute of stoppage time, 6th of 8. It is not going to happen for Korea Republic this evening, but what a night for Jordan. Absolutely nothing fortuitous about the scoreline, the potential result. They've just been better by a long way. Son deep again. He's almost playing as a holding midfielder at the moment. Wants it back and gets it. He's going to beat them on his own if he can. All the defenders double-teaming, and again, he's still going, Son. In the end, the third man did stop him.
They're really fighting for each other, Jordan, and that was, again, more evidence of exactly that. You beat one, you've still got to get another, get past another, and they'll recover and get you back. There's no way through for Korea Republic.
Wonder what will happen with Klinsmann after this. It's pure speculation. Obviously, World Cup qualifying really starts in earnest for the top Asian teams in September. But this is the here and now in the Asian Cup. And Jordan are just a minute or so away from confirming their place in the final. Kim Tae-han. Once more into the area, once more repelled. He's been brilliant, Al Arab, tonight. Nothing will pass, his motto, and he's lived up to it. Now Tamari.
Look at him still going. Musa Al-Tamari lost it, keeps chasing.
We're playing the last minute of stoppage time. Kim Tae-han. It's a brave header, but it's well wide. And that, with Jung Woo-young's effort, might be that as far as Korea are concerned. I'm not sure there's going to be too much to add on past the eight.
Well, the celebrations have started around us in the stands. Great crowd. Muto's seemed to be for a second covering his ears, but I'm pretty sure he's enjoying all of this, taking it all in.
Cleared away, we've played the 8 minutes. Referee's had one look. Can't believe there's much more to add, to be honest. And there is now no chance, surely, for Korea to get back into this. And they don't deserve to. Another look from the man in the middle, and he still says carry on. Would only be a consolation now if Korea did score, but they haven't really looked like breaking through all night. They're waiting for the whistle. The Jordanians, and now they've heard it. It is astonishing. Jordan are in the final of the Asian Cup after a 2-0 victory over Korea Republic. Al Naimat and Al Tamari with the second half goals. And Korea never really threatened to get back into it. Jubilant Jordanians right round the ground, and that's the understatement of the decade, probably. Jordan 2, Korea 0.
Absolutely immense, this performance from Jordan. And they deserve to celebrate like this. Making history once again into the final. One game away from potentially lifting the AFC Asian Cup. What an incredible story.
Never even been in a semi-final of an international tournament. But they are going to be in Saturday's showpiece match against either the host Qatar or Iran, who put out the favourites, pre-tournament favourites, Japan. Nothing Sun Hongmin could do tonight. He hardly got a sniff, in truth. It was just a wonderful team performance. Solidity at the back, Roshan. And two moments of absolute magic up front.
Listen, I it's not even flattering, Jordan, to say, honestly, this could have been more than 2-0.
This could have been four. The chances they had in the first half, they couldn't put away. They put them away in the second. They absolutely deserve to be going through. A brilliant team performance by Jordan. From front to back, back to front, complete dominance against Korea Republic.
It is a fabulous fairy tale, and we haven't written the ending yet. We'll find out what's going to happen with that on Saturday evening. But tonight, they just have to enjoy it. Jordan through to the final. They have beaten Korea by 2-0.